And those watching the markets know that in the past 6 months, they've seen a tremendous rise. NDTV's Oinitham Ojha now finds out exactly the reasons for this.
3, 2, 1,
celebrations planned when the Sensex crossed 34,000 for the first time in the morning and then closing above it. It took just 7 days to cover the last 1,000 points, fastest in 6 months. The Nifty too closed at the new peak of 10,531, up 0.36% on the back of strong buying by domestic institutional investors and enthusiasm among retail investors. But the big question is why, especially given that RBI and others have flagged inflation, high crude oil prices and the worrying fiscal deficit target being increased.
Over the long run, everyone seems to be very confident of India's progress going forward. So that's where most people are kind of discounting the immediate issues, and going forward they actually expect a better sort of fiscal deficit also narrowing and other things.
To expect a return like 2017 of 25 to 28% looks very tough. 10 to 12% upside, yes. And internally we have a string of elections in states.
But investors credit mutual funds and the Gujarat elections.
Local mutual funds are getting the best or the highest amount of inflows from retail investors ever in the history of capital markets.
Mutual funds assets have grown a phenomenal 43% approximately this year over last year and are currently at 23 lakh crore rupees. In New Delhi, Oinitham Ojha for NDTV.
We'll take a short break now. When we come back, an exclusive interview with Priyanka Chopra.